states outside the Tamil Nadu. So I'll explain you the, some of the ways,
Okay.
like in 1 hour session, I'll explain you the detailed things about cybersecurity and what all the crimes they are happening in a real time. And some of the demonstration, I'll explain you with the demo. So first, in today's session, the 1 hour, I'll explain with the introduction about a cybersecurity, and then about a ethical hacking, then cybersecurity, and some security issues. So what are the digital things that are happening in a real time, then some demonstration, and then the security protection. So first thing about a cyber crime, we all are aware of the crime happens day to day. The crime is a thing which is happening anywhere. The thing is, if the crime happens in a network or a digital way, it's a cyber crime. So cyber security are the profession who are having a knowledge in either ethical hacking or some of the penetration testing, like some terminologies you may aware of, some terminologies like pen testing and the exploits. So I'll explain you those things. The person who is giving a security for a cyber crime related activity is a cyber security profession. So cyber security is a thing, the crime happens which is related to a digital way, like either a fraudulence in email or the phones. The crime which happens in a digital way is a cyber crime. The person who is giving a security for those things is a cyber security profession. So the crime, like in a single word, we can't explain the whole thing about a cyber crime. The cyber crime are categorized in some many ways, like they have a email hacking. So in COVID, maybe you'll receive an email, like if you are working from home, most of you are college professors and faculties or research scholars. If you are working in work from home, you'll get a same mail as like from a college. So once you click that mail, you'll get a, you'll be redirected to some other page, and your password, the original mail password, may get changed. The coders or hackers, they used to code likewise. If you click something in that mail, so if you click something, the page or attachment inside the mail, it will redirect to some other page and it will change your original mail password. So these are the email hacking they are doing right now. And then today, the trending thing is IVR hacking. I think most of you are not aware of IVR hacking. So in previous day, they used to call as like from the bank, but the in back end, the person will speak and they'll ask a card number and all the details. So this is some old way of hacking. Nowadays, they are doing a recorded thing. As like they are the call will get as like from the bank as a recorded message. And all are like IVR. Like if you need to verify your bank details, you just press one. And due to COVID, don't come out, all the details the IVR will say to the customer. And then at the end of the thing, please don't come to the bank to verify your account number and all those details. We are help you. So you just type the account number and card details and CVV number. So all the details will be uploaded through IVR. So if you get an IVR call as like from the bank end, don't attend the call, or if you don't respond to the call. So maybe if you attend the call, don't respond to the call. You can directly call to the bank and inquire them whether there is any IVR, or if they are doing any, either you can do a mail or you can directly call to the bank and raise a complaint. So maybe they'll alert all the customers. They'll send a bust SMS and they'll alert the customer. So this is the main thing happening right now. And fake profile. So we are aware of someone may create a memes page or a fake profile, or they'll upload the photo of us. We'll discuss about these things, how to rectify those things, and fake profile, then data theft. The data theft in the sense either a person will upload a file in our system or mobile, and they'll capture all our data, the data set, and phishing. Sorry, the spelling error. So typo error. So phishing is a fake page they have created for like a bank page or a college page. They'll create as like a college page or a corporate page, and they'll have a login portal or a purchase portal. Like consider if there is a portal like the XYJ University, topmost university in India, they are conducting a FTP. It's a free of cost and you can register for 10 days. If there is a link coming to a mail, mostly all of the staffs, they used to click that link. And if there is a login, like you have to log in with the Gmail ID to register for the particular FTP. If the scenario is like that, most of us will give our Gmail ID. So without verifying the URL, we'll give the link, whether it's redirecting inside that college page or somewhere, we'll give our Gmail ID and password. So make sure you are having any contact number and any verification. You just verify once, and then in any person, if they are sending FTP or anything, they won't ask you the password. So if there is a password necessary thing, you just verify them why they need a password. So don't give your password as it is. And then credit card fraudulence. So the credit card fraudulence, as we know, they'll get a credit card numbers from anything like the cookies or somewhere, and they'll use the credit card and they'll get a money from our credit card. And pornography content. So this is a main woman abuse thing happening right now. So pornography things are spreading all around the world. So I'll explain those things. And then copyright content and trademark. So if you are publishing some papers or if you have some patents, if someone is stealing your patent or publishing the papers and publishing somewhere else without referring your name or your paper, so that is obviously a cyber crime. You can file a complaint. There are some laws. I'll explain where to complain and how to rectify those things. So these are something about some most important thing about a cyber crime. There are much more things in cyber crime. So the next one, this is one of some attacks right now they are doing, the homography attack. So I'll explain the thing in a demonstration. Like, consider if you are having a name, some college name, they are having a name like ABC. So if they can create a name as like the same name, but the thing is the value will differ. I'll explain you with the demo so that you can understand properly. So here I just open the simple Excel. The thing is they'll use the same technique to create a URL. So IDN is a internationalized domain name. They'll create a domain as like a fake domain. So like consider the domain name is SNMV or something. So they'll create as like a same name, but the name differs with the value. So the appearance will be the same, but the value will differ. So I'll explain you with one example. So here I just type my name, Dinesh, and then here I'll type the same name as Dinesh. So here is a capital letter. Okay, I just change it to small letter, smaller case. I'll just validate. I'll give a formula equal to here, then equal to this thing. Equal. So here you can see the Dinesh, and Dinesh is a true condition. What I'll do, I'll explain you how the homography will affect in real time. So I'll just open a browser. You can take a screenshot or you can make a note of the URL. And I have uploaded, embedded all the URL in our presentation. So once we complete the thing, I'll share the presentation to the coordinator. You can get the presentation from them. So I'll just type the name as I have typed, Dinesh, and enter. Sorry. So here I'll change the value of D to some other thing. So here is a, you just make a note or you can take a screenshot. So here I have typed Dinesh and I have changed the value of D to 217. And then I'll copy the content from here. So I just copy the name from here and I'll paste the same content in our Excel. We know that already we have validated the content. Now I just paste the name, and here you can see the false. The first one and second one is not true, but the appearance is same thing. Like you can see the same appearance. Don't you view the URL and don't predict the thing, the content is a true content. They may change the URL with the particular thing. So you can see the Dinesh and Dinesh looks like the same, but the value is different. So if I type the original thing, if I delete the D and if I type the original D, the like D, so true content. So I have changed the value of D. Same way I can change the value of I, N, E and S, and I can create a some domain. So I can create as like a Facebook, as like a Google, I can share it with someone. And if the person log into the URL, I can able to capture the data. But the complaint rise, if suppose, think of a scenario, if the complaint rise, they'll take a printout and they'll analyze. But while analyzing, they'll see the same name, like the mail ID is the same name, they can't able to predict. So what is happening inside those things? So this is a thing happening behind the scenario. So this is about a homography. The next one. So as I explained, the Excel, I have added my name and I have added the formula. So and then here is a link you can use and RAT. So RAT is a remote administrative Trojan. Mostly we are using our either Android mobile or a Windows system. The Windows system and Android mobile can be hacked using a RAT. So RAT is a remote administrative Trojan. So there are n number of RAT available in internet. So I'll just show you one example. So here. I have a website here. So here you can see I didn't install this application. If I install, if the application is active, so I can just, you can see here. So this is a window. This is an active mobile. So that is past 1 month before. So if I click manage, the thing is if I share some application to some mobile and I can able to capture all the details. So consider for us, for example, if this is a victim mobile, the from the last, the second one, if I click manage, if the person installed the particular application, I can able to capture the GPRS and microphone contacts from that mobile. We can able to retrieve the contacts. This is a scenario the hackers, they used to do for hacking mobile phones and all the Android devices and even a system. System, they are using a ransomware and all the other tools. I'll explain the thing. So here is a microphone, contacts, call log, clipboard data, notification log, then SMS manager, then Wi-Fi manager, installed application. So all the things we can able to view from the from our end. We don't need to go to that mobile video, don't need to have a mobile of that particular victim and do all those things. From the remote end, we can do all the thing. So there are possible ways to hack the data. Same thing, there are possible ways to secure the data, but we are not aware of how to secure. The thing is, we are using our digital gadgets, but we are not aware of how to secure those digital gadgets. So this is one website. And second one, this is one more, another website. So you can just note down the website URL. Just Google the URL. First, you don't need to log in. You can Google the URL. And here is a download app. You can use as a parental control. Like parental control in the sense, if you are having a daughter or son in your home, you can access, you can add the particular application in their mobile and you can able to monitor, you can not a monitoring thing, like you can able to restrict some of the content using the particular API, that application. So here is a download application. You can download, you can type a captcha code and you can complete the survey, like not a survey, just I'll just 247175 and then I agree, then download. It will download the APK file. So here is an APK file. You can transfer the APK file to your mobile, either using a WhatsApp web or some application, or you can upload in Drive. And you can use the website. In application, it will ask for a login. And then same username and password, you can type here. And you can monitor the other end of the device. So just note down the link pcandroidlink.net. So PC Android. I have added all the things in our presentation. You can go through later. So just understand what all the things available, and then you can work out these things. So this is about a Android hacking or Android crime that is happening in a real time. The next thing, can you able to view the screen? Is it visible?
No sir, no sir.
Okay, I think no, someone sir, has no. presented. That's it. That's why. Okay, I'll represent. Okay, I think someone has clicked the present option. That's the problem. Okay, let me.
It's Asharja Sinha.
No need to mention the name, sir. No issues. Okay, entire screen. Sorry for inconvenience. Let me check. Okay, so now you can view the screen, right? Is it visible?
Yes, sir. Visible.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Sorry. So next one, I have explained about the mobile things, like what is about a rat and the Excel and the homography. The next thing about mate. I think the slide is not viewable. Okay, I just show in the presentation slide. So this is a slide. So here we know that our system and our mobile is not secure 100%. So all the data are sharing somewhere in so our data are there in somewhere. So we need to secure those data. We have already uploaded all the content. So here Google is trapping all our data. So Google has all the identity, whatever the thing you are searching right now, all the data are uploaded in Google database. The Google will have the facility of doing the analytics thing. They are doing a data analytics. So what they are doing, they are capturing each and everyone's data, and then they are giving us ad. So I'll explain you with the demonstration. So here you can see, so consider the person name is Tom Gera, and then the person, the Google knows what are the mail transactions they are having. Even a mail transactions, they can able to view the bank statement, and then contacts, how many contacts they are having, and then YouTube search. So what are the YouTube searches they are doing, and Google search. You may think that the Google search is not viewable. Well, one thing you can just remember, if the crime happens and once the person is a victim, if the police department, the first thing they'll analyze the Google search history, and they'll get a search from the ISP, so internet service provider. So they know all the details. Even if you are surfing in a incognito window or whatever the thing you are surfing, they can able to take the Google search. If they know the Google search, they can able to predict the person. So Google search, they can say, I'm a good person, I can't do, I'm not a person to do a bad activity. So if they search a Google and if they do the monitoring act, analyzing activity, they can able to predict each and everything and each and every day what the person is doing in a backend. And then the Android device, how many Android device they are using, and then Google Play, the passwords, all the thing. I'll explain you the demonstration here. So here, Google will track our history. History, obviously, you know that Google history will capture all our history, and you can view those history in Google My Activity or Google History. You can just Google as Google History. Just you can Google search history. So Google search history, you can do all the history search, and then ads. Most of you will think how we are getting ad. Like most of us, we are getting ad. Whatever the thing we like, we'll get ad. One thing you can just imagine, you won't get a gender. Like if I am a male, I'll get only the male related ad. Like I'll get ads which is related to a male content. If the female is using a mobile with a male ID, they'll get ads related to the cosmetic products and some of the products related to the women. So they have a capability of tracing all those things, I'll explain with the demonstration. So here is a link. I have copied the link in somewhere. Let me check. So here you can see ads. So you can just Google ads settings.google.com. Just keep a note, or you can take a screenshot. So you can take a screenshot, ads settings.google.com, and you just log in with the email ID which you are using in your mobile phone. Like, they have already predicted, like, I'm a male and what are the ads which I have. So here I loved pets and cycling, family. So all these ads will be applied to my behavior. So behavior in the sense, whatever the thing I am searching in Google, the particular thing will be listed. You can see some highlighted thing. So that is the mostly I used to search, like cats and a dog. So comics and animation, these are the things I used to search mostly that will be highlighted. So you can just go to ads settings.google.com. And then the second one is the application. So what are the applications you are having in your mobile, and what are the applications that are using your Google data? Google data in the sense, your contacts, your mobile call logs, all the things will be captured by the Google. So it will be all the things will be captured by the Google, and it will be recorded, and it will be monitored each and everywhere. So this is about myaccounts.google.com permissions. You can see the permission, and you can delete the permission. You can delete those permission. So here you can see the WhatsApp, all the details having our permission. All the datas are accessing in somewhere. The first one is ads, and then second one is permissions, where we are logging, where we are giving all our permission. Mostly we'll install the application, and then at the end of the installation, it will ask you whether you need to allow the camera thing or contacts. We won't really read all those things. We'll just simply press you can agree, and we can I agree to share all my data. So it's not a thing. You have to listen properly, and you have to learn those privacy things. This is about a Google dashboard. Google have much more applications. So whatever the application you are using, you can find here myaccount.google.com/dashboard, where you can find all the Google database. So these are the Google datas I am using. Google services, not as a data, Google services. And then Google takeout. So Google takeout in the sense, Google products. What are the products, the Google products you are using in your mobile or in your system? You can view in this. So Google Classroom and Google Drive, Google Fit. So all the things, Google G Suite. So what are the services which you are using day to day? And what are the services which they are accessing your data? So these are the services they are accessing our data. So here Google Pay, all the things will be there. So now you can know that the Google is accessing each and everything. Like you may forget the thing which you are doing right now, the today. Consider you are in 2030. Google knows all the data what you have did in 2020. So you can open the Google search, and you can view what are the search, and you can even FTP. You have attended the FTP. Some of you may go through with the Google. So if you are after 10 years, if you open a Google, you can view the same content. So what are the contents you are searched in Google, you can view the same content. So this is about Google capturing our data. And then the next thing about mobile, as I said, the mobile crimes happening worldwide. So be aware of mobile crimes. This is about Facebook. So Facebook, they are doing all the activities in Facebook. So Facebook, what they are doing, they are same way what are the datas they are analyzing in Google, they are doing in other end. Facebook has an activity log. You can just note down the link. Just I'll try to present. In presentation, I can't able to view the screen. Let me check. So Facebook privacy setting, most of us, we are maybe we are having a Facebook ID. Some of you, we don't have a Facebook ID. Even you don't have a Facebook ID, Facebook will monitor all your activity using your WhatsApp and other application. So WhatsApp, obviously the copyrights and all the things will be with the Facebook. So WhatsApp has, I'll explain you what are the things WhatsApp is doing. So if you are having a Facebook, make sure you are using in a proper way. Don't use Facebook as it is. So you just, if you are not only the Facebook, if you learn, if you are using some digital gadgets, the digital gadgets will do both things. It will support you and it will spoil you. So it's up to you how you are using the digital gadgets. So if you are using a digital gadgets, before entering or before login to the particular thing, make sure you are reading the documentation and make sure you are reading all the security settings. If you are reading properly those things and if you are setting those privileges in a proper way, you are in a secure state. So one more thing, maybe you'll get a thing like some hackers can hack a Facebook profile or WhatsApp profile. The thing is, if the person can able to hack the Gmail server or Facebook server or a WhatsApp, they can hack into any Facebook account. It's not a real thing like the person can able to hack all the email IDs. Wherever they are having a weak password and weak circumstance, the hackers can intrude into that profile. So if your profile is a strong one, they can't able to enter. They'll try to enter, but if your profile or if you are secure, like if you are not clicking any malicious link or some advertisement link, you are secure. So first thing, Facebook privacy setting, make sure you are doing in a proper way. So you can secure your contacts and you can, there is an option called tagging. If some of your students tag your photo in your profile, you can able to monitor. So once you are confirming, it will list you in your profile. Until then, it will be there in a hidden state. So you can set those things in Facebook tagging and then Facebook face recognition. So if you turn on this setting, in some scenario, consider if I am uploading one of the faculty in webinar. So if your same profile picture is there in the Facebook will recognize that the Dinesh Paranthakan has uploaded your profile photo. So you just go to that profile and you can view those things and confirm. Like that, you'll get a notification. Make sure you turn on this feature so that you can able to view and you can able to monitor each and every activity. Some photos or some mistakes happening with your photo or your profile, you can able to monitor those things. And one more thing, most of us we don't know about how to report. So if something happens in Facebook, we'll close the whole Facebook. So we won't open the Facebook account even. So don't do that. If you report on if some person affected with the Facebook or some instance, just try to report. If you are reporting, maybe it won't happen for someone else. So just have a habit of reporting, not only in Facebook, either a woman abuse or some crime happens, try to report those circumstances. If you report, it won't happen for another person. So try, make a habit. The same reporting is there for all Gmail, YouTube, all the thing. You just go to contacts. Most of us, we won't read out the contact section. Most of you, we'll just go to Facebook, we'll go to WhatsApp, and we'll go to YouTube, and we'll surf all those things, and we'll come out. So there are options. You can apply job in YouTube. You can apply job in Facebook. There is a career portal in Facebook, YouTube, and WhatsApp. You just go through those settings, or you can say inform to your students. So here is a reporting. You can just note down the link, facebook.com/whiteat/report. So this is an official page of a Facebook. They are offering a report portal. So here, if someone using your content, like either a WhatsApp, Facebook, or the Instagram, you can report in particular portal. If scenario, if some of the staff photo is misused in Instagram, you can report those things, and it will take some time of 24 hours. They'll remove the photo. And if someone hacked your account, there is an option. If there is a security issue or if there is a hacking activity happens, they, you can report in same portal. You can go through the report page. You can analyze the thing. You can get to know some more details. And then comes to a WhatsApp. We know WhatsApp is backupping our data in Gmail, Google Drive. Here you can read out the information. Messages and media backup to the Google Drive are not protected by the WhatsApp. So you are doing in third party backup. So they are not doing end-to-end encryption. Maybe you are aware of the WhatsApp having an end-to-end encryption for calls and messages. If you are uploading your data in somewhere else, like a Google Drive or in your SD card, the backup which is there in your mobile and the Google Drive, it's not end-to-end encrypted. The thing is, if someone steal your Google data, so Google, your most of us, we are thinking that Google, it's a simple Google ID, you know, we can give for all the cases, but it's not a thing. If you are not securing your Google Google thing, any person can access all the data of even a personal detail, bank detail, all the data can be hacked using a simple Google ID and password. So make sure your Google ID is safe and secure. And one more thing, if you are changing your mobile or if you are giving a mobile in a second hand or service center, make sure you are uninstall a WhatsApp. Don't do that. You just reset, because the WhatsApp backup will be there in the mobile. Even if you uninstall, you can just think of, if you uninstall the WhatsApp and installing the same WhatsApp after some 2 to 3 days, it will ask you whether you need a backup from SD card or the Google Drive. So you know, obviously the backup is there either in mobile phone or the SD card. So if you are uninstalling, it won't get deleted. Just reset your mobile and then you can give for a service center or anywhere. Then one more thing, application security. So application security in the sense, here in the webinar, I think some 100 plus participants are there. All of you having an iPhone or Android mobile. So I'm just asking a question. Can anyone say the count of exact application which you have installed in your mobile? I think 99% of you don't know about how many applications are there in your mobile, exact count. We can say I'm having some 100 applications, maybe 100 applications, maybe 100 to 200 or 80 to 100. But you can't able to say the exact answer. The thing is, the hackers used to use the same technique. They'll clone the application and they'll have it in your mobile. So what we'll think, they know that what are the applications we are using frequently and what are the applications we are not using for all some long time. So what the hackers will do, they'll clone those applications and they'll install in your mobile. So you can maybe, if you are, for example, if you are having a booking application, like a bus booking application, Make My Trip or some other application, we can't book the bus tickets frequently, like every day we are not booking the bus. You can just have a ticket booking application for some instance. While you are booking, you can have an application. Obviously, we know what is the password. We are using our Gmail ID for a password or the mobile OTP verification. So we can recover the password. So it's not a mandatory thing to have the application permanently in our mobile. So if you are having that application, the application will upload all your contacts, photos, and call log to the the Make My Trip or Book My Show. If you are having, if you are planning for weekend, the Book My Show, you can install in weekend and you can book the ticket and you can uninstall. It's not mandatory thing to have all the applications in your mobile. So make a habit of checking the application day by day and then uninstall the application which you are not using frequently, like Swiggy, Zomato. Maybe you will use 2 days once or every day. So the thing is, if you are having the mobile in your application in your mobile, they'll send you the notification. You'll get to know they'll send you offers. It's not a needed thing. They'll send you pushing ads, all the thing. So they'll addict you for those things. So just have a habit of uninstalling the unnecessary apps and the application which you are not using frequently. So this is how I'm using. So if you need, you can follow those things. And then here, I have explained this. And one more thing about a Facebook. Maybe you have a doubt that I'm having some 400 or 500 friends. So I need to unfriend some of friends from Facebook, or I don't know, some friends who are there in Facebook. You can have a habit of checking the birthday and the past memory. Facebook now notifying about the 1 year memory, 7 years memory, and the birthday of all the friends. You can just open the friend, and then you can look out whether they are using the Facebook for past 1 year. So if they are not using the Facebook, obviously they are not active in Facebook. Maybe they have forgotten the password. So 1 year, one person can't even if they are, they'll post even a single photo. So if they are not doing 1 year or 1.5 year, you can unfriend. If you are routinely doing for 1 year, after that, your Facebook will be fresh by known friends. After 1 year, daily you'll get a notification of birthday. You are doing this shortlisting for 1 year. After 1 year, you all the friends will be your known friends and the active friends. You can do those things. You can try this thing. And at last, the cybercrime portal I have listed. So if you are having any complaints regarding to cybercrime or something, there is a portal called National Cyber Crime Portal. You can complain directly. So if there is a woman abuse in COVID, they have a particular column for report women and children related crime. You can report to the what are the queries, and you first thing you need to collect the evidence of the crime. So whatever the thing, either you have lost your amount in some trapping calls or some messages or mail, you can collect the evidence. What they'll do, they'll delete those things after they completed the payment gateway. So just have a habit of collecting the evidence, record the call. When you're getting a call from someone else, record the call, note down the numbers. So have a habit of collecting evidence, upload all the evidence in cybercrime portal. Within some 24 hours of time, you'll get a call confirmation whether you have reported the particular complaint. For that, they'll give a call, and then you can directly go to the nearby. They'll help you where you can do and how you can process the complaint. So you can do those things by cybercrime portal. And for a security, the final thing, as I have discussed about, and one more thing I have left, for a password security, there is a portal name, how strong my password is. There is a portal here, how strong my password is. You can just go to this portal to check your password. Like I just type my password. So here it will take some 2 billion years to get the data, get the password of the thing. So you can try with this website and have a better password. Like if your password is there in the dictionary, the hackers can able to hack your password within some 30 or 50 seconds. So have a habit of checking your credential. So on, say for a security, use a proper antivirus and firewall. If you are not aware of what is firewall and antivirus, you just Google it. So there is a difference between firewall and antivirus. And one more thing, if you are having a paid firewall or paid antivirus, most of us, what we'll do, we'll purchase a firewall or antivirus, we'll install in our system, and we won't update the antivirus for 1 year or 2 years. Have a habit of updating your antivirus, because the updating is necessary to kill or to find the recent virus. So if the virus is there, yesterday, if there is one virus popping in Google, the antivirus tool, consider Kaspersky, need an update to capture that particular virus. So have a habit of updating frequently. and then don't open the attachments from unauthorized source. So if you are getting a mail from someone else, which is there not in your contact and it's not with the attachment, if you are getting a mail, don't open or don't respond to that mail. And one more thing, keep updating a latest security update. So I'll just give you some small hint. Maybe you know that you are a staff members, maybe you are aware of this. If you need a cybersecurity thing, just cybersecurity. I won't specify a particular Google's particular website for updating, whereas you can use Google for updating. Just search cybersecurity. Here is a tool. Instead of any time, change to past hour. So you'll get updated content 1 hour before if there is any cybersecurity. Consider cybersecurity webinar. So if you search for cybersecurity webinar, you can update cybersecurity webinar 1 hour before, like 34 minutes. They are conducting some webinar related to cybersecurity as of we are doing. So you can search, if you need a webinar, you can search webinar in India, webinar in some country, and search the Google search past hour. So that you can register a webinar as quick as possible. So this is about updating thing. You can do lot of things with Google. And so this is not a ethical hacking webinar. So if it's an ethical hacking webinar, I can handle you much more things. This is about a cyber security and cyber awareness. So here is a update your, keep update yourself with the latest technology and have a habit of getting up, taking a proper backup of your system or mobile, and don't have a sensitive data either in your mobile or in your PC. Have a habit of previously past 10 years back, all of you will have a CD drive and you will copy the DVD. So do the same thing. It's some 30 rupees or 40 rupees. Do the same thing. If there is a sensitive data like your paper or your pattern, you just have it in your DVD instead of having in your Google Drive. So you can copy in some 2 or 3 drives. Maybe you'll get a thing like if I miss those things or if the CD breaks, you can have a copy. So and then don't share your sensitive data with someone else and delete your passwords from your browser. And last but not least, please educate your family and friends about a cybersecurity. So cybersecurity is one of a trending and emerging technology. Same way, one side they are updating, one side they are spoiling with cyber, the digital gadgets. So please update your family and friends about a cybersecurity and about awareness on cybersecurity, how to use a digital gadgets, so that we can able to get something after some 5 years or 10 years, they'll get some updated things and they can be secure. So this is about cybersecurity. So finally, if you need any clarification or anything, you can Google just Hackup Technology or my name. So you just Google for contacts or some other thing. You can just Google Hackup Technology. You can just Google, we are in Coimbatore. So you can Google Hackup Technology or you can search my name in Google, Dinesh Paranthahan. So here, you can find me. So here, then finally about myself. So I can't, I didn't add about me in the first slide of presentation. Usually the presenter will present about me in first slide. So without any content, I don't want to share myself in first slide. So maybe you are something you know about the content. So about myself, I'm an ethical hacker and pen tester and guest speaker. So we are running a firm, Hackup Technology in Coimbatore. And our service, we are doing ethical hacking. And BAPT is a vulnerability assistant penetration testing and infrastructure security audit and public compliance. So if there is any complaint related to, like your photo is posted in somewhere else or your someone, they have misused your data or something else, we are processing those complaints. And then development service we are having. So we are developing a security software and education service. I'm a guest speaker and we are doing a workshops, hackathon and webinars, all those things. So this is about myself and you can search my name in Google so you can get all the details. And then I'll share you the review link. If you like the webinar, you can give a review. And then for workshop or any queries or any webinars, you can contact a particular number. So this is about the cyber security. Hope you all just understood something. So it's 1 hour of time. I can't able to handle all the things. The cyber security is like a ocean. So I think I have covered some little bit of things in the 1 hour of session. So if you have any doubts, you can turn, you can just unmute and you can ask your doubts. If you're having any queries, you can unmute and you can ask your queries.
Yeah, good morning, sir. I'm Shankar Kumar Mukherjee. I'm speaking from Kolkata.
Yeah, good morning, sir.
Yeah, can you please tell me something about the cloning of credit cards? I have heard a lot of thing about cloning of credit cards or debit cards. Can you please tell me something about that? That will be, I will be very happy.
Yes, sir. They are cloning the credit cards, but you need the security things, right? Cloning credit cards. There is a website to clone. That means not a cloning credit cards. They are two methods they are using. One is a thing. They are cloning the credit cards which they are using in some other end. Like sir has asked the doubt. If they are having a, if the sir having a credit card, if I am cloning the sir credit card, it's like a cloning credit card. And one more scenario, they are having some random numbers as a credit card number, and they are misusing to purchase some products online. So the two scenario is there. They are cloning the credit card, as you said, but you have an application. If you are having a bank application, or if you are having the app in your mobile, the application has a facility to monitor your credit card. You can unblock and you can block the credit card whenever you are needed. So in other end, they are cloning with the ID and the CVV number and the credit card number. They'll get using the fake link. So what they'll do, consider there is a some course like a forensic investigation course. It's a worth of $5,000. Due to COVID, we are offering for faculties for $5. So you can use your debit card or credit card. They'll have a portal. So using this method, they'll clone the credit card. So how we can secure in the sense, in our application, in all the credit card application, we have the part like you can pass your credit card and you can you can freeze your credit card. You can just freeze your credit card. Whenever you are using your credit card, you can turn on. So obviously we are having, you are using mobile phones all the day. So you can have a mobile app and you can turn on. Whenever you are going for a purchase, you can unblock and you can purchase.
If anyone, I am from Chakdoh, West Bengal.
Yes, sir.
Dr. Vikramar Mondol. If anyone is interested to deactivate his or her Facebook account, what are the procedures?
Sir, deactivating is a possible thing in Facebook, but we can't delete the Facebook account. So the Facebook has an option for delete or deactivate. In the settings button, privacy setting, you have an option for delete or deactivate the account. But it will take some 3 months of time to deactivate. Once you deactivate the account, another person, like consider your name is ABC. If I am searching your name, I can't able to view the particular profile. So we can able to deactivate the same thing. If someone is having your mail ID and password, they can reopen the Facebook after some 1 year or 2 year. There is a possibility of reopening the Facebook. So you can deactivate, same scenario, we can reopen it. So all the things will be there in the privacy setting. So here is a privacy setting. You can just scroll down in your Facebook. You can find there is an option for deactivate and delete.
Okay. Okay.
Any other doubts, sir?
Hello.
Hi, sir.
Sir, this is Dr. Vinod Kumar from Rajagopal Polytechnic, Gudiyatam. Hello.
Hi, yes, sir. I can hear you.
Sir, how I know that my mobile is somebody has seeing or how can I know that?
Sir, you can install the application. Like the hackers, they used to steal our data. So not to upload or anything. So the hackers mostly what they'll do, they'll hack our mobile and they'll upload our data. So you can have the application called firewall. So there are n number of firewalls available for Android. You can install, there is an application called no root firewall, free firewall. The firewall will intimate you whether some data is uploading from the hackers in. So you can pass those data. If there is any some malicious behavior happening in your mobile, you can able to block.
Okay. Thank you.
You can install the firewall in your mobile.
Okay. So another thing, if you are going to log in some website, sometimes they are asking to manage your password. We have to give manage
the
password.
Don't need to manage the password. Whereas if you are into the bank portal, they'll ask you to manage the cookie, not a password. For a bank scenario, you have to give as a manage cookie. So don't need to manage a password. So managing password is not a mandatory thing. You don't need to give a password. And one more thing, have a habit of having a different password for all the mail ID, Facebook, and all the thing. Have a different password.
Okay. Thank you. Kind of you, sir. Thank you.
Hello, good afternoon, sir. Hello.
Yeah, hello.
Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon, sir.
I am Vinod Kumar from Tiruvarur. So what is the difference between an IDN and a GPO?
Pardon, sir, IDM?
IDN and a GPO.
IDM, where they are using, sir, IDM and GPO?
Sir, hack technology, IDN, identification name changes.
I thought IDM. So IDM, GPO is group purchasing organization, right?
Okay, sir. What are the major difference, sir?
No, sir, we are not using those technology. So, so IDN in the sense, I'm not using those technology. IDN.
Okay, sir.
Like you have IDN, only thing we are using in that homography, right?
Yes, sir.
IDN, what they'll do, they'll change the value of the name. They'll change the value, like as I said, if the name is a Dinesh or some name, they'll change the value of those names and they'll create a domain with the particular name.
So this is about IDN.
I don't know about other thing which you have asked. Maybe if you have mail, I'll verify and I'll send you the thing.
Okay, sir. What is the main purpose of GPO differ from IDM?
Sir, GPO, I didn't use those things, GPO. So IDM I have used in domain. So GPO, I know, I'm not aware of.
Okay, sir. Thanks.
GPO, I think policy, some policy, GPP we have used, group policy performance. But GPO, you can mail to us and we can reply.
Okay, sir.
Any other queries?
Okay, sir.
Any queries? I have posted my review link in the chat box. You can post.
Hello?
Yes, sir. Hello?
I wanted to ask you just one question.
Mm-hmm.
What exactly is the difference between threat, vulnerability, and risk?
Sir, there is a terminology like exploit, vulnerability, and threat. So vulnerability in the sense, if you are having a glass door in your home, obviously the glass door, anyone can break into the glass door and they can come inside the home. So there is a the glass door is a vulnerability. The tool which they are using to break the particular thing is a exploit. So the vulnerability is a weakness which they are having in a web portal. And the tool or the code which they are using to get into the website is an exploit. And the threat is a small piece of code. Like the code maybe have a malicious behavior or some code which is doing a malicious behavior in system. But the code which is having a facility of breaking into the vulnerability is an exploit. There are three or four terminologies: threat, exploit, vulnerability, and one more thing as a target. So these are the thing. So vulnerability is a weakness, and how or through which medium you are breaking into the vulnerability is a exploit. and small piece of code is a threat. Sorry, clear?
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Yes, okay. Sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. So, any other queries? If you have any queries or anything, you can just post here. So, here is a mail ID, Dinesh at Hackup Technology. Or if you have any queries, you can just WhatsApp. And if you if the webinar is informative, you can just have a review. So you can give a review. So I have posted a review link in our chat window. So you can post a review. If you have any doubts, you can ask your doubts.
Hello.
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 Yeah, hello.
I am Dr. Ganguly calling from Calcutta.
Yes, sir.
I have one query. Mm-hmm. What is dark web? Mm-hmm. And is surfing the dark web punishable under Indian cyber laws?
Yes, sir. Not surfing dark web is illegal. First, I'll clear with what is about a dark web. So dark web is a thing they are doing in a Tor. So Tor, I'm using a Tor browser for R&D and for some purpose to download some tools and some other thing. So dark web in the sense, some of the Google use a crawling method. So whatever the thing you are Googling, consider if I Google SNMB, I'm getting a college name. So this is happening through a Google crawling. So the dark web, it doesn't have any crawling method or a search engine and doesn't have a .com domain. So all the dark web domains will be in the format of .onion. So consider there is a, I just refer you, you can just Google it. So there is a website named Hidden Wiki. Hidden Wiki. You can just Google Hidden Wiki and you can get to know all the details about the dark web and how to use a dark web. The surfing dark web is not a illegal thing, because the illegal things are happening in dark web. As a security profession, we can search those things and we can secure those things which will happen in real time. In future, we can able to secure. Thus, surfing is not a illegal thing. Whereas if you are purchasing something in dark web or if you are using some services in dark web, if they are get to know that you are using such a service, it will be an illegal thing. The surfing is not as a illegal thing. Is that clear?
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Hi, sir.
Hello.
From Coimbatore.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, what are the ways of securing our mail, maybe other than this two-step verification?
Mail and WhatsApp, you can give two-step verification is a mandatory thing. And one more thing, have a habit of keeping a strong password, because as I said, you don't need to click the unwanted link or Gmail unwanted attachment which is falling in your inbox. Don't click those things. If you are clicking the hackers, they'll either send you the file or they'll hack your Gmail account using some dictionary attack. If the two things are not happening with your Gmail ID, your Gmail is a safer site. So they won't hack the direct Gmail server. If they do the data breach of the Gmail server, they can able to hack the worldwide password. So they can't do those things. Whereas for our security, we can secure with the password, and you just analyze what are the mails. You can filter. As I said, you can unsubscribe some of the mails you are getting frequently day by day. You can unsubscribe all the mails. So this is how you can secure. And for WhatsApp, you can use same two-way authentication.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Okay. So any other doubts? Any other doubts?
Hello, sir.
Hello, ma'am.
this is Upasana Saikya. So we have been using a lot number of apps like Google Pay, Paytm, Phone Pay. So how far are these apps secure?
Ma'am, some of the applications are like Google Pay, Paytm. These are secure app. They have a secure payment gateway. The thing is, nowadays they have a UPI facility, right? So if you are getting a message like please transfer the payment using UPI, we have received some complaints regarding the UPI. So some of you will send a mail or message like same like you. They'll share so and so, I'm a staff from this college, I'm in critical situation, please I need a money through, share the amount through UPI. So don't share the amount through UPI. The only thing though, you can use a bank account in Paytm or Google to share the transaction, or you can directly have a mobile number, so which is connected with their account. So if you are sharing the amount with UPI, the other end hacker, they can able to regenerate the UPI once they receive the payment. So the cybercrime persons, it's a tedious process to identify only with the UPI. So other than that, the all the security, the apps are secure. So how we are using, like transfer the amount in a proper gateway. So they are having a gateway, but while sharing, don't use a UPI. That's it.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. And I thank Abel Thangaraj sir and the management of SNMV for arranging this wonderful session. So for discussing at the morning, I'm discussing with the faculties from various fields and various states. So it's a great honor for me. Thank you, sir. So is there any query? You can post a query. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Very good morning to all. It's my privilege to propose vote of thanks. First of all, I would like to thank our dynamic principal and our management for happening of this FTP. On behalf of our institute, I would like to express my sincere thanks to our guest of today's session, Mr. Dinesh, CEO and founder of HackUp Technology, for sharing your views today, sir. Thank you, sir. I also express my thanks to all our participants of today's session. Thank you, one and all. Thank you.